All right, folks, the deck is Odd Rogue. The goal of the deck is to use their hero power early and often to out-tempo our opponents until their hero explodes. Just because she's fun, we've also got a Seraphine Fleet Runner in our deck for a little bit of chaos. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can catch me live at twitch.tv/Rawful. Just gotta go faster than the hunter. Shall we dance? Keep the deck hand, the pull patches, and look for like Trog. Oh!
None will survive.
Brutal. Game one, draw patches. Play your quest and get on with it. We all know you're gonna do it. There we go. No, you're not coining this, are you? You are? Are you out of your mind? Dies too easily, but maybe worth. I didn't think it was going to die that easily, but. It's unlikely to be a very good matchup, to be honest. Might as well have some fun. Actually got a fair amount of damage. Maybe I don't even need to worry that much about it. Just race them. Ends up being damage. Let's go here, here. No, I should have punched. Actually, no. Yeah, Kotobane is really slow. I'm not a big fan of him in current lists.
Oh.
Looking for these.
I think we get there. Obviously, they kill the spinny boy, but this is seven. I'm one off. I should have swung the turn that I had the chance. if they're able to kill the Abyssal, it might be tough. That might have been I missed a hero power at one. I missed 2 damage at one point when I could have used it. Wait, they can't get the Tavish down and kill both of these this turn at least. So that means the Tavish comes down a turn slower. Gonna be close. Ah! Yeah, I botched this. There's one turn where I didn't swing. The turn that I played the Seraphim, I could have paced it out better. And honestly, I probably shouldn't have even deleted the deckhand. Like, this would have been a win if I were better. Or if I had played better. But I couldn't help myself.
Valera versus Gul'dan.
Shall we dance?
Keep the buck. Switch these two. I think Leopard Gnome's probably fine. Frog? I hear they rule. I can go Trog, Leper into Buck Hero Power on 3. Or I could just go Trog Hero Power, Bash Bash, Buck Hero Power on 3.
Armor! Armor! Lightly used armor!
The Iron Divine is mine!
I ain't talking! Feed up!
Was a mistake.
I mean, I'm not entirely sure that just... Yeah. Bummer. But that's one rat gone.
Armor.
Mechathune? It could be Mechathune, it could be Owl. Both look pretty similar at this stage in the game. So
side effects? No.
Largely run about the same, like 27 or so cards. I haven't really seen any of their healing yet is the problem, but at least they're not dropping a rod early. Okay, Okay, there's the touch or defile. Oh no, it's the okay, this kind of leads me to believe it's Owl, because I don't think that Mechathune often runs that card. I honestly don't know how good it is in Owl, or in Owl Warlock either, but... just gonna coin the passage so I can play 5 drops, if I so choose. These remain in hand after I transform them, right? So that's honestly probably the play, right? I left a... because I'm also worried about the Tamsin.
These. Oh, I'm just bothering them.
Do I ever beat Tamsin? Like, I'm not great into Tamsin regardless, right?
Time's ticking.
I'm gonna save them because I have the prize plunder in hand. But, like, this is a pretty obvious Tamsin turn. Not. Oh, the rod. This gives me... I don't have an elemental. I mean, they probably need to go. Wait, maybe it is Mechathune? What's my last battle cry? Xerathan? No, it was the... ugh.
How complicated.
It was the mage guy. Yeah, the hero power. So what I can do is go elemental this. Save the bird for next turn to get a geyser. And it'll repeat this battle cry, which should be active. So I'm assuming my board gets cleared pretty much every turn from here on out, but I'm also maybe dead. The only big chunk of card draw they have left is Tamsin. But yeah, this looks like Mechathune, which means they have to empty their deck? Yeah. Gotta be Mechathune if they're doing this play.
Side effects? No. Trust me.
That's bad for me. So much healing. And they're almost through their deck already. No! It's GG. Bye. Oh.
That's all for you.
That's a cool play. I mean, it's the main reason why people started putting Phylactery in the deck. A pretty standard play for the deck. I thought it was for getting ratted. I mean, that's half of it, but like most, like it's not a good rat metagame right now. Very few decks are running rats because it's not good. Was expecting quest road, but they mulligan the quest slot. Just gonna go one drop, double one drop, and then a buck hero power on three.
Here for a chat.
No.
Why, hello.
I'm here to play Hearthstone. Why does Phylactery didn't discover an egg? An egg hadn't died yet. Damage. Both eggs were on the board when they played the Phylactery. Well, I've got a lot of damage this game. Let's point it at the opponent's face. Uh-oh. I just ignore that. Send everything upstairs in the form of minions this turn. Set up a checkmate unless they have like some form of healing, armor gain.
Want a combo meal?
No. It's not gonna save them here. Hit the leper gnome? Hit the gnome? Oh. Alright, I'm noticing That the first game that we didn't play the Seraph in, we won the game. Obviously, there were other factors involved in me winning that game, but like, maybe Seraphine isn't that great.
Valera versus Rexa.
Shall we dance? I mean, we just keep the Trog against Hunter, right? Probably don't need the Pheasant. Because he just dies way too easily.
None will survive.
We have turned our curse into our
strength. Oh, it's even Hunter.
The Iron Divine.
It's maybe a better matchup overall, though. Explosive. Oh, someone forgot what Trog does. Hey, Marion. A recent opponent would like to be my friend.
Shall we dance?
Wow. That was a lot of tour guides. Odd versus odd. The ultimate. Go down. I want to go here and here next turn to give them two important threats because, like, if I just play out the Pheasant here, he's going to die. As the opponent will soon find it.
Feed the fish, lock lover.
What is it?
Yahara. Get to her hands here.
Yeah. Gotta kill the Pheasant. I'm just gonna float a mana here, I think. Minions go face, face goes minions. Aggro deck 101. I've got terrible, terrible, like, Curtis positioning if they discover the 4-mana Curtis.
What is it?
Hey, I got you, friend.
where my weapon's going. One. I need a one mana card. Two. Really have much mana in hand to work with anyway, so this is fine. Well, maybe I would have. Almost forgot to attack there. We appear to be in a pretty good spot though. It's nice when an aggro deck doesn't have an infinite value. Yeah, imagine that. Yep, win the board, win the game. Just Hearthstone fundamentals, that one was. Against Hunter, this is actually not bad, right? On one. It's no Iron Deep Trog, but it can draw me into one. And I just always keep the Lotheb. But it might, like, force out the coin. The only turn that, like, doesn't actually make sense. They're not even, so... Like, worst case scenario for me, it forces out the coin here, I think. I'm gonna swing hero power next turn, so. My minion placement is terrible. Because of like Grievous Bite and Bola Shot. Forgot that those are cards. Their coin. I don't really want to play either of those this turn. Jeez. There's got to be a better hit than this, right? Yeah, Leprenomen is. Next turn is Lofeb. Then I go in on the 2-1 drops. How are they doing on this? Oh. That's not terribly concerning. Gotta be the best turn for the Lothab, right? That prevents them from completing the quest. Oh. Probably explosive. But. Let's go face anyway. I can't feel good.
Home in the shed.
Feed the fish, last lover. Feed the fish, last lover.
There's no combination of cards that doesn't result in them losing from here, so. Not sure what they're looking for. And maybe they just want to see what's in the box, because I do. Let me see what's in the box. BM? I mean, how is it not BM for them to play a whole bunch of cards when they're in an unwinnable position? How is that any different? I was just responding in kind. Unfortunately, Pheasant isn't likely to get value because they just hero power into it. I'm just gonna pitch him away when I'm on the coin. Swing, swing, hero power again next turn. Then I have it set up for the Bulbara. I don't want to go too hard on early game minions necessarily. Like, this is burst later in the game, even into Spreading Plague and Poison Seeds, so it has some value. Need to dodge a token summons on 4. I mean, that helps if they have it. Not a bad hit off of the nature studies. I see a lighter glitchy. Deals with the Spreading Plague.
Give me that. Not what I want.
Pyroblast is really tempting, but like Flame Strike can essentially be a Pyroblast. Kind of tips off that they don't have a Spreading Plague in hand, otherwise they'd be more inclined to let that stay up, I think.
Feed the fish, landlubber.
What is it?
I don't want to use the coin here because I might, they might like draw into a Spreading Plague and I might want to Flame Strike it. Coin. So. Let's see. Weird that they took that trade, but if this is what they're setting up. But this is also what I've been preparing for. Certainly not out of this yet.
Here for the tour.
All right. It's a lot of armor that we've already chopped through. Dragon in hand. Oh, they had a second one. I'm doing it, chat.
These. Oh, I'm just bothering them. Nightfall.
Yo. All right.
Been a while since I've seen that card. They've still got one more Spreading Plague in their deck, too, is the unfortunate thing. Ugh. And I lost the Lotheb. And they're just gonna slam a dragon here, I think. Or not. Maybe the dragon in hand is Kazamicus. Yeah. It might be tough to win from here. Especially with that. Jeez. This is not a good matchup for me now, is it?
Frost bites sharper than fang.
Still not threatening lethal, though. Breath of Dreams doesn't give a mana crystal? No, I think it's bugged with Guff right now.
I'm the Broodmother. Don't you ever forget.
That's a bummer. I had just forgotten, too.
Class dismissed. Now time for the real
massacre.
This just dies. So I should have played it earlier, but... Oh, I didn't think it was going to work that way. Nice. I was just trying to not draw it again. Our armor is not what they needed. No space for the Dreadsteed, yeah, but 1-1 isn't really a thing that helps me in this matchup when they still have another Spreading Plague. Oh, looks like GG. In reality, I never stood a chance.
That rope's burning again.
Kind of a strange split there.
That's all for you.
I mean, they actually did make up a card there. There is no card named Armor Breaker that exists in Hearthstone. No meme. Pretty good opener. Especially with the buck.
None will survive.
Here for the tour.
Wait, why did I just hear a power there? That was dumb. Or swing, rather. In my head, I played the tour guide next turn. Maybe I should have.
Fly, Polly!
Pirates away!
Yaha!
Ooh. I think just the first flame, right? That Evo is tempting, but there are some bad outcomes that can happen. You're going face? At least they eventually traded. What a terrible, horrendous, outrageously bad draw for me. Oh my god. Can't even play a card this turn, but, or a minion this turn because of that. Like 80% of the deck is one drops and I just missed completely. But I need to save the buck in hand so that I can attack into a captain or something along those lines. Jeez, what another horrendous draw.
Feed the fish,
I'm gonna hold the weapon here. them not swinging for the next couple turns. This is, I mean, these two back-to-back draws are how I lose. I was in a pretty good spot until I hit them. And I just get blown out by their next stage of the quest anyway. I don't know what they're doing. But it's certainly helping me out.
The iron is mine! It's mine! Give me that! Love what I want! Oh.
Why? That's the wrong one to kill. You're not gonna get punished for it, so it doesn't matter. So frustrating. Top deck. Set sail! This matchup is so favorable, it doesn't matter how poorly the opponent plays. They have played quite poorly. Okay, this is my only chance, I think. This is actually pretty good with the cannon shots.
Steal from the rich and give to the poor.
All hands on deck.
Yeah. I mean, it just, it literally doesn't matter how badly you play the deck.
That's all for now.
Opponent had so many opportunities to raid and just kept shoving face. It's not how you play the deck. It's never been how you play the deck in that type of matchup.
Valera versus Anduin. I will protect my legacy.
Shall we dance?
I think I just keep the plunderer to pull patches. Not the best one drop, but what I have. I just need to not get behind. Let's actually go here.
Regal.
The shadow engulfs us.
Okay. This rogue first on the stream. No, somebody literally just answered you. I've also been streaming for 4 hours, so. But no.
Valyra versus Tyrande.
Shall we dance?
None will survive.
Go again, I guess.
The shadow engulfs us.
Sure. This looks familiar. EK, thank you for the 50 months. My sub is so old, it's almost considered AARP benefits. It's getting there. Really appreciate that. Thank you for the support. I'm gonna take the coward's line here. The opponent is slightly more aggressive than I, so I don't want to take three from them. Hey, I've got one of those. Good save, Raffle. Good save. No one even noticed. I think most other cards I was going to favor the Secret Passage, but that's a lot of damage. They've already used one Mind Blast, right? Why though? Go for lethal. Double deadly poison. Or this plus deadly. Thanks for the whelps. It would be nice to win a singular game of Hearthstone with Seraphine, but she is just so bad. The bummer. When will you change the decks? About 2.5 hours ago and 1.5 hours ago. So I will change them in about that amount of time. Okay, I'm keeping the Seraphine. I haven't learned from previous games. Oh! I only mulliganed one card, you idiot!
None will survive.
Stupid patches.
Ahoy, scallywag.
Why, hello.
Also, in about 20 hours, yeah, that'll probably be the next deck change. This turn looks like deckhand hero power anyway. I've drawn patches way too many times. But, hey, turn. Imagine not drawing your patches. Couldn't be me. What if we do this?
What is it?
They've already indicated they don't have the first mate. Maybe I can sneak a draw in. I could use some more cards. Can't play the weapon. Okay.
Feed the fish,
lover. Love what I want.
Job done. I like where this is going. Wait, they left the pheasant up. They didn't leave the pheasant up. Wait, you think I'm gonna learn from any of my previous mistakes? No. I need to save this in case I need to hit like a cannoneer or a captain. Which means I'm probably playing the cutting class next turn while it's cheap, and then the secret passage after that. What is a really strong control deck in Wild, in your opinion? The only viable control decks right now are slow druid decks with some sort of finisher at the top end. They're taking some damage here, but it's so gross. Turn is going to depend pretty heavily on my top deck here. I get the cannon shots, but there's still a turn out for Rokara. Don't. Oh my god! Oh, you're so lucky! Oh! That probably cost me the game. I had 4, 8, 11. Yeah. That's pretty close to GG. That's a very good draw, at least.
Impurity will not be tolerated.
Here, here. Maybe just take the secret passage instead. But we're kind of looking to get going. And no deadly poison this turn, I just need to kill that. I think I'm actually just gonna YOLO this. I don't have much time to.
You disgust me.
What do we get here? Over here. Second Avenging Wrath. Do I have any dragons? I have a dragon in my hand, right? Yeah, I have the 5-mana Paladin Dragon. I cannot believe that. Still get there. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Captain kills, doesn't it? Captain would have been one off. That would have killed with the captain. God, I couldn't even enjoy that game. BM? Once again, they left lethal on the board. They could have conceded. At any point. Like, they continued playing cards when they couldn't win. How is that different than me doing it? Therathan finally did something? Yeah. Jeez. God, I hate that deck so much.
Valera versus Valera.
Finger match.
Shall we dance?
Probably more likely to be a quest rogue, though. I just want to be able to take out their. Well, I just go face. I don't even pay attention to what they're doing. Fire Warrior is just a miserable experience no matter what. That is how I feel as well. Very hard to have fun with the game while that deck exists. I think I just go for the most aggressive line possible in this matchup.
Why, hello?
Oh. This is not the quest I thought it was going to be. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to coin the Seraphim because the opponent is playing a fun deck. I think it's only fair that we do the same. Raffle, when did you vow to never play standard? I didn't. So, never. Oh wait, the hallucination kind of makes them miserable, doesn't it? Like their pace of play makes me miserable. Now I'm not sure how much I want to have fun with this opponent if they're going to do this.
Your tour ends here.
You have a diamond rag? Yes, I had some excess dust that I recently used to craft them. Or to craft the remaining cards. I think I had like two or three missing pieces. You know what? I just I'm tired of getting roped every turn. The opponent's not going to be fun. Neither will I. This could have been fun, friend. Could have been fun. But... Does this happen often? Yes. Wait, that overrides the Lothab? Yeah, I guess it does. Okay. Free monkey? We know they're not Reno because they played double clever disguise. Ooh! Double monkey! Oh, return to monkey chat. God, I miss this guy. Look at how happy he is to be swinging that sword.
This timeline amuses me.
You gonna rope me out of the last turn too? That's good, at least. All right. We got some Seraphim footage. I think I can be happy with how this deck did. How did we end up doing, actually? What is that? 8 and 12? Not bad. Alright.